Intellectual property is one of your biggest assets. Intellectual property is the fruit that you harvest after putting in all of the hard work and money and effort to get your business going. It's your brand name and values. It's your videos, blog posts, training material, and other content. It's the useful inventions that you could patent. It's also the techniques and practices that you've perfected and refined to allow your business to run smoothly, efficiently, and profitably. We call these trademarks, copyrights, patents, and trade secrets. To get the full benefit of your intellectual property, you need to take steps to protect it. Trademarks, patents, and copyrights need to be registered to get the full protection. Trade secrets need to be kept secret. And in each of these cases, you need to monitor to make sure that nobody is using your intellectual property inappropriately. If you neglect this, you may lose some of your enforcement options. Businesses with strong IP portfolios are more valuable. So if it ever comes time for you to sell your business or merge with someone else, having a strong IP portfolio gives you an advantage. How does a trademark help your business? This is your name, logo, or slogan, and it helps your business stand out so that you cannot be confused with other businesses that are like yours. For example, would you confuse Coca-Cola and Red Bull? No. Coke's branding is famous for emphasizing the experience. When you see commercials and advertisements of Coca-Cola, you see people hanging out, partying, dancing, falling in love. That's their brand image. Well, what do you see when you see a Red Bull commercial? You see people taking chances, taking risks, extreme sports. That's their brand image. Even the cans are shaped differently. These companies have poured a lot of effort into making sure that there is a unique image associated with their brand. And believe it or not, your business either has that or should or will have that. And you want to make sure to protect that unique brand that is yours so that it's different from anyone else's. Those are the brand's qualities and is what makes them distinct. This distinctness is what you should protect about your brand. It's your trademark. You should make sure to create some aspect of your business that makes it different from others. For example, my law firm only helps small businesses. Around me, there's law firms that will help anyone with any kind of a problem. They'll do criminal, they'll do divorces, they'll do estate planning, they'll do small business. When people call me, they know they're getting a lawyer who only handles small business issues. That is part of my unique and distinct brand. What is your unique and distinct brand? When you do have a trademark, whether it's your name, your logo, your slogan, or something about your products that makes it distinct, you protect your trademark in the US by registering it with the US Patent and Trademark Office. You should have an attorney, like me, help you with this. It begins with an extensive search to make sure there are no other registered trademarks that are similar to yours. Then we file an application, which is pretty simple, and a lot of people will choose to do this part on their own, thinking that this is all there is to it. However, there is another important step. After you wait a while, you will typically get some kind of a rejection or office action from the trademark office, which requires you to prove that your brand is distinct enough to warrant trademark. An attorney will help you respond to those office actions and help you plead your case to the trademark office to help ensure that your brand gets the registration. This helps keep your brand safe and secure so that no one else can register it or use it in a confusingly similar way. How will a copyright help your business? Copyright is a kind of property right that protects your creative work. And I don't just mean art. Computer source code, engineering documents, they warrant just as much protection as a novel, a play, or a music recording. Businesses create blog posts, they create videos, they create training documentation, they create presentations, they create content all day. And all of this can and should be protected. What can't be protected? The two main things we think of today are, first, content created by non-humans. The famous example is the monkey selfie. A photographer had set up his camera to get some animal recordings, and an ape came along, grabbed the camera, and took a picture of itself. The man tried to copyright that, and it was refused because it was determined that the monkey took the picture, and monkeys do not get copyright protection. The other example is machine-generated content, such as AI. Lately, it's been very popular to use tools like ChatGPT and Stable Diffusion, DALL-E, in order to create content automatically by telling the computer what to do. The position right now is that this is not copyrightable. The second category of things that cannot be protected are collections of data and facts. Because these are not creative works, they do not get copyright protection. In order to get copyright protection, at least a little bit of creative work has to go into it. So phone books, for example, cannot be copyrighted. To get full protection, you need to register your copyright with the Copyright Office in the US. If you don't register, you still will own the copyright, but your enforcement rights are weakened. If you want the full protection over your creative works, then you do need to register it. Those protections include the ability to sue for money damages and attorney's fees. So how does copyright law affect startups? Well, for one example, I recently saw a video of a YouTuber who was complaining that people were stealing their videos and posting them on other platforms, and even impersonating this person's brand. Well, right there is a copyright violation. If this YouTuber had registered their copyrights, they would not only be able to do a takedown in order to ask the other platforms to remove infringing content, but they would be able to go after the infringers for money damages. Another big thing that affects startups is open source software. Many companies who create products use software that was created by others. This is fine as long as they use it with permission. Open source software usually does not require payment, and instead, it simply has a license agreement that requires things like attribution or sometimes sharing your contributions back. If you use open source software, it is still copyrighted material and you do have to follow the terms of the license. Not following the terms of the license could mean that your products or services get taken down due to unauthorized use. Make sure to have all of the necessary permissions to use the software and the components that you're using to build your software. Again, if you need help registering a copyright, while you can do this yourself, it is usually best to have an attorney like me help you. How will patents help your business? When you create a new invention, whether it is a tangible product or software, you may be eligible for a patent. The patent process is complex and it requires its own video. But in short, you must document and publicly disclose the details of the invention that you want to patent. For some people, this is a deal breaker because they do not want to publicly disclose how their gadgets work. Once granted, the owner of the patent gets a 20-year monopoly to market and sell that product. Patents are country-specific, so it is common to register patents in multiple countries. Patents can offer significant protection to your company, even if your company is struggling and maybe even failing. We've seen some very high-profile cases where companies who were in the decline got purchased for very reasonable amounts of money because they had a great patent portfolio. Two examples are Motorola was purchased by Google in order to allow Google to have access to their patent portfolio. Nokia was purchased by Microsoft, also to get access to their extensive patent portfolio. However, both of those were related to the mobile industry that is extremely competitive, and patents are required as table stakes to be competitive. But most businesses benefit from having a patent portfolio. If your business has patents that are essential to your industry, you may be able to make money by licensing your inventions to other companies, which means that they would get to use your technology in exchange for paying you. Or maybe if your business is struggling to stay afloat, you would be able to find someone to buy you out and acquire your business to pay off your debts and maybe even put a little cash in your pocket so that you can walk away gracefully. Aggressively pursuing patents is a very good business strategy, and we see many companies use this. If your company is not actively looking for inventions that can be patented, then you're missing an opportunity. If you need some help with this, please contact me and I can help you create an intellectual property strategy that gives your business a greater chance of success. Let's talk about how trade secrets will help your business. When we talked about patents, remember, we said that patents must be publicly disclosed. Well, if that's no good for you because you want to keep your ideas secret, then a trade secret is probably the right route for you. Trade secrets do not get registered. That would completely defeat the purpose. If you have a certain way of doing things that sets your business apart and it gives you a competitive advantage, then that is a trade secret. The most classic example of a trade secret is Coca-Cola's secret recipe for their drink. In order to get the protections for a trade secret, first of all, you do want to talk to a lawyer because there are some steps that you have to take, with the most obvious being one, you have to take commercially reasonable steps to keep your trade secret a secret. If you don't keep it a secret, then you will lose all of your protection. For example, recently a restaurant tried to say that they had a trade secret, but they had told their recipe to everyone. There were tons of employees, family members, friends who knew the secret recipe. Because it wasn't a secret, they had no protection. Another example that we saw in the news not too long ago was an engineer left Waymo's self-driving vehicle division in order to go help Uber start up their own self-driving vehicle division. Well, they took secret knowledge with them, and Waymo sued Uber to stop them from using the secret knowledge that this employee had. Protecting your trade secrets gives you a big competitive advantage. You've put a lot of time and money into making sure that your business is successful. You do not want a competitor to come in and leapfrog you by learning from all of your experience without having to put in the work. Don't let your rivals benefit from your hard work. If you need help creating a strategy for identifying which intellectual property assets in your business should be and can be protected, please reach out to me or to another attorney, because this is going to give your business a huge advantage. I am Matt Newsom with Iowa Business Lawyer, and I'm here to help your business succeed.